Lions, have you been wondering what to do for your March birthday? Well, I have the perfect idea. You can go to Chuck E. Cheese's. But what is there to do at Chuck E. Cheese's? Oh, there are lots of fun things. Let's go look around. Test your strength and see how strong you are. You can slide down the slides. Play air hockey with your brother. Bring it on. Or you could shoot some hoops. And when you're all done, just look at all these prizes you can pick from. And now let's zoom on into those March birthdays. Whoa! Are you tired of eating junk food like McDonald's and Taco Bell? Well, I know I am, and I've discovered a new way to put dinner on the table. It's at my girlfriend's kitchen. Let's go inside and find out what's cooking.
Welcome to my girlfriend's kitchen.
Hi, Mrs. Allen.
Hi, Savannah.
This is Mrs. Allen, one of the co-owners of my girlfriend's kitchen at Lakeside Village. How does all this work?
Well, you book a session for 2 hours and you come in and put dinners together. We've done all the work. We've cut up your meat, we've chopped up your vegetables, we've sauteed your onions, and you come in and follow these easy recipes and put them together to take home for healthy, nutritious dinners for you at home in your freezer.
Wow, that's just like making a dinner at your house.
Exactly, only you don't have to do all the cleanup because we do it all for you.
That's the best part.
Your mom would really like that.
I hear you have something fun going on here on Thursday night.
Yep, on Thursday nights we have, the first Thursday night of every month, we have a teacher night where they get to come in with their session and get a free dessert.
That's a good idea. So instead of grading papers and then having to go home and fix your own dinner, you fix it for them.
Absolutely.
So do any guys come in here? Because my dad, he's a teacher, and he has to fix supper sometimes too.
Yeah, we love it when the guys come in. As a matter of fact, they like coming so much that we actually started a date night too. So guys and girls can come in together on Friday nights twice a month, and they can come in together and cook.
That's a good idea. Mm-hmm. So the parents can have their own night out.
There you go.
Ooh. So what is this already set out for us?
Well, the reason that we have this area is because the cooking experience and the social experience are both important, and so we have an area that you can sit between making your foods because you're going to make either 6 or 12, and sometimes when you make 12, it's a lot of work.
That's a good idea. Mm-hmm. So you better come out to my girlfriend's kitchen for a great supper. I think I'm going to stay here and cook some meals for my family. So save time, save money, eat better, and have fun at my girlfriend's kitchen. Back to you, girlfriend. Have you ever seen the inside of an ambulance? Well, hopefully not. But I know you've all heard those annoying siren sounds going by school all the time. But those are good sounds. It means they're on their way to saving someone's life. But the best part yet is they're just right around the corner. They're the paramedics, our community helpers.
Help. I need somebody. Help. Not just anybody. Help. You know I need someone.
Take a look at all this equipment in here, all the things they use to help people out. It's so amazing. And the defibrillator is what makes these three things happen. I can get my blood pressure taken, my pulse, and the functions of my heart. And we owe a big thank you to these guys right here. They really help us out. Well, according to all these cords hooked up on me, I am still alive, and I know that my heart is in good hands. I'm Savannah Collins reporting from the EMS station.
When I think about Valentine's Day, I think about hearts and candy and love, but especially flowers. Flowers that look good and especially smell good. So why don't you stop by Petals to get a beautiful arrangement for your mother, grandmother, or even your Valentine. Let's talk to Miss Marks, a floral designer, and see what's available. So tell us what you're working on, Mrs. Marks.
A dozen roses.
Well, you're doing a very good job. And about how many dozen roses do you make for Valentine's Day?
Approximately 400 dozen.
That is amazing. And how long have you been in the flower business?
37 years.
And what made you choose this profession?
I enjoy using my creativity and being able to make people happy.
That's a very rewarding job. You might want to choose a bouquet of roses for your friend or loved one. So when you're choosing those perfect flowers, you might want to grab a stuffed animal to go along with it. I'm Savannah Collins here at Petals Flower Shop in Lakeland.
Hello, I'm Savannah, the silly, kooky, crazy scientist, and welcome to my laboratory. But now back to the experiment. Today, I'm going to make a concoction of festering foam. First, I'm going to take baking soda and put it in the vase. And then, I'm going to put water in the vase. Then, I'll give it a nice stir. Next, I'll put dishwashing liquid and two types of food coloring. And then I'm going to put it in the vinegar, which will make it foam like crazy. But first, I have to give it a nice stir again. And now it's time for the vinegar. 3, 2, 1. Wow, look at that! That is amazing! It keeps on oozing as long as the reaction continues! And speaking of reactions, I'm getting a little crazy as you can see, preparing for FCAT! And my brain is overflowing with information. So if your brain is like mine, here are some helpful hints. Be positive, just relax, it's only a test. Get a good night's rest. You want to be well prepared. Eat a healthy breakfast. Do not eat any sugar. And be on time. You don't want to miss any directions. And after the test, smile and be proud you did your best. Now I have to get this brain to work correctly for the FCAT.
Teachers at Lime Street to talk to her about an awesome thing she did last Sunday. She ran in a marathon. How long is a marathon?
A marathon is 26.2 miles.
And where did it take place?
It took place in Disney in Orlando. We started off at Epcot running, and then we went through Disney World, then we went through MGM Studios, we went through Animal Kingdom, and then back to Epcot.
Wow, and I get tired out from just walking around one place at Disney. How did you train for the run?
I trained several months before the marathon started, and I would get up early in the mornings before school and run about an hour, and then on weekends.
Man, that is a lot of dedication. And how long did it take you?
It took me 6 hours, 24 minutes, and 18 seconds.
Did you ever get a break?
Yes, I did take a few breaks. I got some water and I stretched out a lot.
That's a relief. Thanks, Miss Rogers. That takes a lot of dedication and endurance.
just like we need to do at school. I'm Savannah Collins reporting for PAL.
Hi, Coach. Well, it's a beautiful day for the walkathon.
Yes, it is. We have great weather today.
Are you pleased with the way things are moving?
I'm very pleased. Our students are very well behaved, and our teachers are out here helping us. It's a great day.
What do you intend to do with the money that you earn from the walkathon?
You know, Corinthia, our jump ropes are breaking in half. The balls have holes in them. We don't even have enough equipment for 90 kids at a time. So that's the kind of things we're going to be buying this year.
Well, sorry to say, Coach, but I've noticed. Anyways, what lap are you on?
I have completed 8 laps. How about you?
Same here.
All right.
Well, I got to get back to walking.
Well, you know what? You walk, I'll be running. If you want to join me when you're done, come on.
Well, Lions, I'm Corinthia Johnson reporting from the PE field.
Welcome to Great American Teaching. I'm here with Heather from Mulberry High School. So, what is this horse's name?
This is Montana.
Is it a boy or a girl?
He is a male. He's a gelding.
How much do you feed it a day?
About 2 scoops twice a day of sweet feed.
And how much does it weigh?
About 1,200 pounds.
That's a big horse. Well, I see you have some other animals here.
Yes, we brought a baby pig, a rabbit, a turkey, 2 chickens, and 2 goats.
I hear you're a member from FFA. Can you tell us what that stands for?
FFA is the Future Farmers of America. We deal with livestock and food and pretty much the development of agriculture.
Well, thank you for taking your time out today to come visit our school. I'm Brianna Detwiley reporting for Lion Kingdom News.
What is that big purple and blue thing out there? Is it a tractor or a lawnmower? Well, it can't be a lawnmower because it's on ice. Maybe we can ask him what it is. Here I have Mr. Mike from the Lakeland Center to ask him about that big and blue purple and thing out on the ice. What is that?
It's a Zamboni ice resurfacer.
How did it get that name?
It was developed by a man named Frank Zamboni, I think in 1914, and it just kept the name ever since.
Well, what is it doing to the ice?
It takes a thin layer of ice off and then replaces it with water.
Okay, but what is the water coming out of the back of the Zamboni?
Well, because we take the little bit of ice off, we have to replace it. The water comes down, then it freezes within about 5 minutes.
That's cool. Well, thank you, Mr. Mike. I'm Savannah Collins reporting for Lion Kingdom News.
Y'all ready for this?
Well, Coach, it looks like we did it again. We won the participation trophy.
We did, Aubrey. That was the 15th year in a row.
How many participants did we have?
We had 295 students there, and Lime Street had over 1,200 people attending the race.
Is that the most we've ever had?
That is actually the second most, so we did a great job.
Way to go, Lions! Did you like having it here at Joker Merchant Stadium?
Actually, I did, Aubrey. I think it went very smooth. We had a great course for the runners, and all of the parents and teachers had a great, comfortable place to sit.
I enjoyed the course, too. Well, I'm Aubrey Fuller reporting here at Joker Market Stadium.